Okay, everybody, hello. I'm gonna teach you two different methods of creating a Gmail account without an SMS for completely free. And these are methods I haven't seen anywhere else online. The first method is to use a private browser and use a proxy. The reason that Gmail asks for an SMS is mostly based on what kind of IP address that you're logging in from. So the first step for doing this is go to Dolphin Anti into Google. And the first one here, you can download it. It is completely free to create 10 free profiles. And then after you do that, you can open up Dolphin here. You'll get this page. So you'll have browser profiles, proxies, etc., etc. In the browser profiles, you press the create profile link. You can name it whatever you want. The rest of this doesn't really matter. You can tag it for YouTube. You can put the status as ban, ready, new, etc., etc. And this is what's important. So you select the proxy here. So you put new proxy and you put the information here. Now, the second step to this is that you need a proxy to log in with, and this is very easy. So you go into WebShare, into Google, and you'll find WebShare proxy right here. And when you sign up completely for free again, you'll get this page here. And then you'll get a proxy list, again, completely for free. I'm not paying for this. This is all free for me. Now, what you do is that you take the proxy address, you copy it, you go into Dolphin here, you paste it, you put a semicolon, you take the port, copy it, semicolon, you take the username, copy it, semicolon, and you take the password, copy it, semicolon. And then you say create profile, and then you click on this profile and it will open a new tab and you can open Gmail with this. Now, the problem with the free proxies is that they are shared by many people. So there might be issues like here, this one connecting with the proxy. If that's the case, you can try another proxy. One of them will definitely work. And if you don't want to go through the hassle, you can pay for the proxies here. They're pretty affordable. They're something like $1 each. Now for method two, if you simply cannot, if it keeps asking you for a phone number, what you can do is go to this website. So you can type in quacker.io. So this is a SMS verification website. You go down to what country you want to verify the SMS message from. Let's say I want to go to Japan or America, and they have American phone numbers here. So what all you do is you copy and paste this phone number into that, and the message will come up here automatically. And this is shared by a bunch of different people, so you'll see their messages as well. Here's someone's one-time Amazon password. Again, this is completely free. However, because of the nature of this free program, a lot of people are using this to register Gmails. So you'll have to go through a couple of different ones to find one that actually does work. But it does work if you keep trying. You can also try the less popular countries like UK, Germany, depending on where you're from. I'm putting a list of free SMS verification websites into the description. I'm also putting a list of a paid SMS verification website that I personally use. It's about 50 cents per verification, but it works every single time. And that is it. Thank you for watching, and have a good day.